students, today we discuss about break. There are many types of breaks. In breaks, there are block break, shoe break, band and block break, drum and shoe break, and disc break. In block break, there are also three types: single block break, double block break, pivoted block break. In band break, there are two types: simple band break, differential band break. And band and block break, there are two types: simple band and block break, differential band and block break, internal expand. In drum and shoe break, there are two types: internal expanding shoe break, external expanding shoe break. In disc break, there are five types like mechanical break, hydraulic break, pneumatic break, electric break, electrical break, and automobile break. Now in block break or long shoe, here diagram is shown. There is angle of contact less than 45 degree. Also, normal reaction and frictional force mu n are concentrated at the midpoint of the shoe, and it is not applicable for long shoe. So in long shoe, in block or shoe break consists of blocks which are pressed against the surface of a rotating drum. The block is either rigidly attached or pivoted to the lever and lined with friction material. The frictional resistance between the frictional lining on the block and drum retards the motion of the drum. The block is generally made up of softer material than the rim of the flywheel. These brakes are commonly used in railway trains, tram cars, and bicycle. The block or shoe brakes are further classified as single block break, double block break, and pivoted block brakes. This is the diagram of block break for long shoe. Here the diagram, there is theta is semi block angle, d phi is the element of friction lining, phi is the location of friction lining element, r d phi w area of the element, w is the width of the friction lining parallel to the axis, dn is the normal reaction on the elements. Here all the forces on lining and forces on drum are shown. In single block break, there is all forces are acted as shown in figure. Also in double block or shoe break, when a single block break is applied to a rotating drum, an additional load is produced on the shaft bearing due to the normal reaction. This additional load produces bending of the shaft. Hence, to overcome the drawback is double block or shoe break is used. It consists of two blocks or shoe at the opposite ends of a diameter of the wheel, which reduces the unbalanced forces on the shaft. The upper ends of the brake arms are set together by using a spring. When an actuating force P is applied to the lever, the spring is compressed and the brake is released. The force P is produced by using an electromagnet or solenoid. Okay. When the current is switched off, there is no force on the lever and the brake is automatically engaged due to the spring force, hence there will be a downward motion of the load. All these concepts are covered in long shoe. In long shoe, all the concepts are covered. After this, block break or pivoted long shoe. It is already discussed that when the angle of contact is less than 60 degree, then the intensity of normal pressure between the block and wheel is uniform. But when the angle of contact is greater than 60 degree, the unit pressure normal to the surface of contact is less at the ends as compared to the center. In such cases, the block or shoe is pivoted to the lever instead of being rigidly attached to the lever. Due to pivoted block or shoe, there is uniform wear of the brake lining in the direction of applied force. In these brakes, the location of the pivot is selected such that the moment of frictional force about the pivot point is zero. Figure shows the pre-diagram of the pivoted shoes. After this is pivoted long shoe force diagram. After this, some problems discuss about this pivoted double block like such types of problem asked in exam. A pivoted double block break similar to that in figure has two shoes which subtend an angle of 100 degree. The diameter of the brake drum is 500 mm and the width of the friction line is 100 mm. The coefficient of friction is 0.2 and the maximum intensity of pressure between the lining and the brake drum is 0.5 Newton per mm square. The pivot of each shoe is located in such a manner that the moment of the frictional force on the shoe is 0. Calculate the distance of the pivot from the axis of the brake drum, the torque capacity of each shoe and the reactions at the pivot. After then we discuss about internal expanding brake. In internal expanding brakes, a shoe pivoted at one end and subject to an actuating force. Friction lining peaks on the shoe, complete assembly of shoe lining and pivot is placed inside the brake drum. Internal shoe brake with two symmetrical shoes are used on all automobiles. After this, there is some assumptions like the intensity of normal pressure between the friction lining and the brake drum at any point is proportional to its vertical distance from the pivot. The brake drum and shoes are rigid. The centrifugal force acting on the shoes is negligible. Coefficient of friction is constant. This is the internal expanding brakes force diagram. All these forces are covered in internal expanding brake force diagram. Okay. These are the internal expanding brake final equations. This is used for solving problem. There are some advantages like simple constructions, more reliable, little maintenance, small braking force can produce a large braking torque, protection against foreign particles. There are some disadvantages like relatively poor heat dissipating capacity can become self-locking due to wear if improperly designed. There are some such types of problems like an internal expanding brake with four identical shoes is shown in figure. The actuating hinge pin support a pair of shoes. The actuating mechanism is designed in a such a way that it produces the same force on each of four shoes. The face width of the friction lining is 50 mm and the maximum intensity of normal pressure is limited to 1 Newton per mm square. The coefficient of friction is 0.30. Calculate the actuating force, the torque absorbing capacity of the brake. This is the simple band brakes. In simple band brakes consist of a flexible band which is wrapped partly around the rim of the drum. The flexible band is made up of leather, ropes or sometimes steel line with friction material. During the operation, the band is fixed and the drum rotates. The frictional resistance between the band and the drum will introduce a braking torque on the drum. There are two types of band brakes, simple band brake and differential band brake. In simple band brakes and differential band brakes are shown in figure. These are the problems on differential brakes. Like a differential band brake is shown in figure, the width and the thickness of the steel band are 100 mm and 3 mm respectively and the maximum tensile stress in the band is 50 Newton per mm square. The coefficient of friction between the friction lining and the brake drum is 0.25. Calculate the tension in the band, the actuating force, the torque capacity of the brake, find out whether the brake is self-locking. So, the solution of this problem we discuss about in next lecture. So, today we discuss about the types of brakes. Thank you all of you.